Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Omaha Steaks. Stay tuned to the end of the episode to find out how you can save 74% off your order this Father's Day. Hey everyone, welcome back to Inside Gaming for Friday.
That's right, it's Friday. Yes!
Yes!
Yeah!
Yes!
Apex Legends set the world on fire almost 4 months ago when it released out of the blue and accomplished the impossible. It knocked Fortnite off its throne forever.
Can you believe that a god would bleed? Yeah, it actually set records at the time and quickly rocketed up to 50 million players, which was really impressive.
It's now the biggest game in the world, Adam.
That's
the
right.
Biggest game in the world.
It was an Avengers, Secret Life of Pets 2, Aladdin.
Oh, wait, no, wait.
Oh, no, nope.
That was 4 months ago, and since then, the game couldn't maintain that early momentum.
Sad news. Man. Play the sad thing. Its numbers have fallen off on Twitch, and its arch nemesis Fortnite has long since regained the lead. We checked Twitch numbers today, like journalists do, and Fortnite was at 157,000 viewers, while Apex was doing a tenth of that at around 15,700.
This is what happens when you stop paying Ninja to play your game.
Right, Brian?
Boom, got him.
Okay, good.
Brian, why'd you stop paying Ninja?
I only had 1 million. That was it. I was tapped out of it.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Brian, what about financial analysts? What are they saying about EA and Apex?
One really dunked on the game. He said last month that Apex was overvalued and that most of its early popularity was artificial. Wow. Kind of a stinger there.
But developer Respawn Entertainment is chugging along with the updates, and Season 2 of the game's Battle Pass is coming along.
That'll get me back in. So could this be the boost that Apex Legends needs to get back on top, Ryan?
Well, let's see what they're doing. So in a post on Thursday, lead product manager Lee Horn talked about some of the new features that are coming in Season 2. And the first one, starting Tuesday, there will be a new limited time event called the Legendary Hunt that'll give you all kinds of sweet new skins and bonus experience. So your gun will look all sweet.
They're also going to make it easier to level up your pass.
Okay.
Going forward, the pass will have a mix of daily and weekly challenges so that even if you're a casual player, you can still make some progression.
Yeah, Horn wrote, quote, "While we don't want to introduce wacky challenges that drastically warp the way you play the game, these challenges should provide some interesting variation from game to game."
Or, you know, offer something.
Yeah, anything.
As opposed to the nothing that we have now. So, yeah, the idea is to keep you playing on a regular basis, which is pretty standard for the games as a service model, but they're also trying to make progression quicker to keep the casuals interested.
Brian, what else are they adding?
More legendary items.
Yay!
You love them, but I love them. There's going to be more. They're adding 3 more to the Season 2 pass, and there'll be new legendary items at levels 1, 25, 50, 75, and 100. So that's why you want to level up that battle pass. You want to keep getting those new items.
Do you work for EA, Brian?
I feel like I'm Billy Mays over here.
You're going to want to update those numbers. We got 1, 75, 50. Get them, and you get a hat.
Horn said their goal is to have a balance of, quote, cool character exclusives and cosmetics for everyone, like weapon skins.
Of course, yeah. It's very, very important to keep your gun looking pretty.
We know that.
Gorgeous, very, even. Very also, in Season 2, you'll be able to craft whatever legendary item you want using a reward called the Crafting Medals, which we've seen in the game before.
I think they already give those to you, and I don't know what they're for.
I've dabbled in there. I don't know.
So that's what we know at this point. They're going to do a live stream next Saturday, June 8th, to tell us more. There are also new characters planned. We've seen some alleged leaks of what they might look like, but no official word yet. All right. Brian's so excited in my throat. Who's the new character?
Well, we look like we've got one that you can spray on your car, and it'll get all kinds of grease and wax off. It's only $59.99.
Did he hit his head?
No, no, characters, Brian.
What are the leaked characters? What do they look like?
I think his name is Bob and he shoots stuff.
So right now, I guess Respawn is still going full speed ahead on Apex Legends, but how is the game doing overall?
Oh boy, the short answer is still making money. It's not as much as it used to.
Oh no.
It's kind of like most of us.
Yeah. Tell us more about that, Brian.
Well, it's dropping fast. The researcher SuperData reported that the game's revenue dropped by 74% in just 2 months.
Well, that's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah. It made $24 million in April, but that was down from $92 million in February.
Whoa. It's a massive drop-off, and it feeds into a lot of people's belief that the game's popularity was artificially pumped up when it launched, but then quickly tapered off.
If we look at the Twitch numbers, once again, over time, they tell a very similar story. There was a huge spike in February, and it's just been going down, down, down.
We need to pay Ninja to watch our videos, because then when we pay Ninja to watch our videos go straight up all the way to the ceiling.
Sure.
We make $92 million, right?
Do you think he sees people's faces anymore? Or he just sees numbers. numbers. Hello, nice to see you, Mr. 3 million. Good to see you, Mr. 1 million.
It's like the Matrix. He just sees the code.
And it's all blue, like his hair.
After Apex Legends peaked at 674,000 viewers at launch, it averaged about 14,000 viewers over the last week.
Yeah, some of the, you know, the good guys are trying to keep it going, crafty.
I think the game is great still.
It's fun, but they just have added nothing. So, I mean, that's a pretty clear indicator that people checked it out and have just moved on to other things or old things.
Ryan, what about Fortnite? What's going on with that?
We should note that Fortnite quickly stole a lot of the features that people really liked about Apex Legends, like the ping system and the respawn mechanic. So those are all available now in Fortnite, and those are kind of the big differentiators for Apex Legends.
And in the months since Apex launched, Fortnite has continued doing what it does best, just pumping out.
So more content.
You know those dances your kids are doing at the bar mitzvahs? It's from Fortnite.
I had a big collaboration with the Avengers Endgame movie. You may have seen it. It's a small little indie.
Little indie flick.
Now doing something similar with John Wick 3.
Yeah, Apex is trying to play the same game as Fortnite, but it's finding out that's really, really hard to do.
Yeah, it's really hard to stay on top. And Respawn has also said it's not going to overwork its development team and just stick to seasonal updates, which we appreciate.
Absolutely, it's totally admirable.
Nice. That's very nice.
It also means it won't be able to match Fortnite's content pace ever.
Oh, man. But there is a bright spot, right, Brian?
Yeah, I mean, there is still a base of players that's sticking around on Apex. It's still, like, I think a top 20 game on Twitch. So Respawn's probably hoping that if they make them happy, I don't know, maybe they'll tell their friends, kids around the schoolyard, more people might come back eventually.
That's how most games succeed, on hope.
And schoolyards. And now that they're going into Season 2, they'll need to do better than the first season of the Battle Pass, which underwhelmed a lot of players, including myself.
Yeah, right here, too. Yeah, we'll see what happens, but it definitely seems like it's going to be make it or break it time for Apex coming here real soon.
Yeah, I don't think they're reaching Anthem levels of low.
No.
But Apex just push a little more content, a couple more characters, it'll get me back in. I was actually just the other day, I was like, I want to play it again.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'd like to play it again. I think it'd be fun.
It's frustrating looking at a game like Fortnite that I have no interest in playing whatsoever and seeing all the cool stuff that they're doing, where getting rid of Tilted Towers and doing these updates here and there. If Apex could just do a percentage of that,
that's true,
I would totally be into it. But as of right now, it's the same freaking map that we started with. So it's like, why go back? It's nothing new.
Exactly. Brian, do you think that maybe you can force people at EA to work harder on Apex Legends?
I think I'm going to drive around to schools in my panel van and tell the kids to play Apex Legends.
You should not go near schools.
You're not allowed to do that. That's illegal.
And quick shout out, very happy birthday to Autumn, our editor on the show. Hey, Autumn.
Yesterday. Yay!
It was yesterday.
Quick shout out, yesterday is Autumn's birthday yesterday. I thought it was this Saturday because that's when the party is. We got her a clown. It's me. Hey everyone, thanks for sticking around. Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Omaha Steaks. And like I said, you can get 74% off by using the promo code INSIDE this Father's Day to get the Steak Fix gift offer. Omaha is dedicated to delivering the very best, and guess what? We agree. That's why we have their steaks on this desk, where Lawrence normally sits. We've all had great experiences with their food. It's some of the best stuff. It's the meat that you love, but they also got more than that. They got these great, amazing apple caramel tartlets that will just make your mouth water, and I love getting them. I love making them, and that's why we're very happy to have them as a sponsor. So right now, Omaha Steaks is giving a very limited Father's Day gift offer to our viewers. If you go to omahasteaks.com and enter code INSIDE in the search bar, you'll get 74% off the Father's Day Steak Fix gift package. It is a $235 package, and you're getting 74% off. You get the whole thing for $59.99. That is a steal. The offer includes more than any one father or fathers could ever hope to consume, but we commend you for trying, so please give it a go. The pack includes chicken meatballs, filet mignon, pork chops, and so much more. There's a giant list. Can we get a shot of the list of all, it's so much in there. And if you actually order with our code, you get 4 extra burgers with your order. So why would you not do this? So please do not wait. This offer ends soon. Go to omahasteaks.com, type INSIDE in the search bar, and get the Father's Day Steak Fix package today. Thank you, Omaha. Have a great weekend, everyone.
We're in because it brought in $920 million in revenue last year.
I guess Fortnite gets Endgame, yep. But PUBG got Suicide Squad, so.
Gotta be award-winning.
What does Apex got? Suicide Squad. La Llorona.
Yes.
Suicide Squad.
Croc looked great.
Yeah.
I am Croc. It's time for me.